Hello students, welcome back to my channel Engineers Academy. Now I am going to discuss this example. This is based on the rectilinear kinematics. In this problem it is said that during a test, a rocket travels at 75 meter per second, and when it is 40 meter from the ground, its engine fails. Right? So let's say that we have this rocket. So when this rocket is at a 40 distance from the ground, so then its rocket fails, and then it moves at that particular point, the velocity is 75 meter per second, right? So when the rocket is at 40 meters from the ground, so its initial velocity, let's say at this is that point A. So at this point A, the velocity is 75 meter per second, and this point A is 40 mm from the ground. So let's say that the position of this rocket from the ground is SA. Right, so it is said they determined the maximum height SB. So we have to find the maximum height SB, right? So let's say that the maximum height of this rocket is that if the engine of the rocket fails, so this means that it will move freely, right? So when it will move freely, so then what will happen, that its velocity will decrease while it's going upward, and eventually it will stop somewhere. So we are asked to find that somewhere, that highest position from the ground where it will stop, right? So it is said they determine the maximum height SB reached by the rocket and its speed just before it hits the ground, and we have to find the velocity when the rocket just hits the ground, right? And it said that while in motion, the rocket is subjected to a constant downward acceleration of 9.81 meter per second square due to gravity, neglect the effect of air resistance, right? So while solving this problem, first we have to set our coordinate system, right? So first we have to define our coordinate system. So the origin for the position coordinate S is taken at ground level with positive upward, right? So in this problem, in this solved problem, the positive position direction is taken upward, right? So if I write, so then this is our positive S direction, right? And if the velocity is increasing in this direction, so then that will be our positive V direction as well, right? So this is our positive S direction. So this is very important to understand this, right? So this is one of the reason that I am doing this problem, since it's very important whether we need to take the acceleration as negative or positive in this case, right? So then to find the maximum height, what we need to do in this problem, we are given the velocities and we are given the positions, right? So now this means that and since the acceleration is constant, this rocket is moving with constant acceleration, so we can use those three equations of motion, right? So one equation is V equals to V naught plus ACT. These are for constant acceleration equation, right? Then we can use S is equal to S naught plus V naught T plus half ACT square. And similarly, we have V equals to V naught plus 2 ACS minus S naught. So as we can see that in these two equations, we required the time value, and since in this problem there is no time given, right? So there is the everything given is in velocity and position, right? And the acceleration, right? So this means that we can only use this equation in this problem, right? So to use here, it is said that since the rocket is traveling upward, so it's we have assumed that this is our positive S direction, right? So the positive velocity direction will also be in this direction, right? So since the rocket is moving upward, so then the velocity VA is 75 meter per second, and it is the positive, right? So in this direction it is positive. And at maximum height, S is equal to SB. So let's say that when the rocket reaches the maximum height, so then the S is equal to SB, right? So the final position while the rocket moves from A to B is SB, right? So if we write that VA, that is the initial position, when we talk about the motion of the rocket from A to B, let me write that for motion A to B, let's say the initial velocity VA is 75 meter per second, and the initial position SA is how much? So it is 40 meters, right? And when it reaches B, so then the final position S is equal to SB, right? And this is the initial, right? So I can write that this is S naught while using this equation. So S naught is equal to SA, which is equal to 40 meter. And the initial velocity V naught is equal to VA, right? And similarly, the final position V is, this is the final velocity, right? So now we have, we can use this equation, right? So this is V equals V naught plus 2AC S minus S naught, right? So this, then this is V and V naught is VA, right? So this is V naught is VA plus 2AC and S minus S naught. So S is SB minus SA, right? So this is that required equation that we can use, right? So first we have to identify the equation for ourselves in these kind of problems, right? So here it is written that for the entire motion, the acceleration AC is minus 9.81 meter per second square. This is very important. Why? It is said that negative, since it acts in the opposite sense to the positive velocity or positive displacement, right? So if for the entire motion, the acceleration due to gravity is negative, right? So you people have to understand this. The reason that I am explaining, I am solving this solved problem, I am discussing this solved problem is due to this thing. So you people must understand this, right? So why the acceleration is negative? So as we can see that when the rocket is moving from A to B, right? So when it is moving from A to B, so its position is like this. But as we can see that since this rocket is moving freely, so then the velocity at this point, let's say that the velocity at this point is VA dash, let's say. So VA dash will be less than VA, you people know it, right? So this means that this is the final velocity. So if we want to find the acceleration between these two points, so what will be the acceleration? So let's say that I write that this will be the final velocity minus the initial velocity divided by time. So this is the acceleration definition. So since VA is less than, VA dash is less than VA, so this means that this change in velocity is negative, right? So I can write that this is negative change. So when this change is negative, so as we can see that the acceleration is negative, right? So whenever the rocket is moving, if our coordinate system for the position is positive in this direction, right? So if we say that, if we assume that the upward motion is positive and if the velocity is increasing in that direction, so then the acceleration will be positive, right? But if the acceleration is, if the velocity is decreasing in our coordinate system that we have defined, so then this means that the acceleration will be acting downward. So now when the rocket is moving from A to B, the direction of acceleration is downward, right? So this means that we will use the acceleration due to gravity as minus 9.81 while using these equations, while using this equation, right? And similarly, when the rocket reaches this point, so then what happens that the rocket travels in the opposite direction of this positive S, right? So then still at the while the rocket moves from B to C, so still the acceleration due to gravity will be negative. Why? Because let's say that at this particular point the velocity VB will be zero, right? So when the rocket moves downward, right, so then the velocity will become negative, right? Is this direction, when the motion is moving in this direction, so then this will be considered as minus S, right? This is in the opposite to the positive S direction, right? So when the particle will move in this direction, so then the velocity will be negative in this direction, right? So at this point, let's say at this point the velocity is, let's say, minus 3. This is assumed value, right? So this is not true. Let's say that at this point the velocity will be something else, but I am assuming that, let's say, the velocity at this particular point is minus 3. So now when the rocket will move here, will reach this point, so then let's say that the velocity at this point is, the velocity will increase eventually since the particle, this rocket is moving freely towards the ground, right? So the velocity will increase while moving in this direction, right? So then let's say that the velocity is minus 6 meter per second, right? So again, if we find the acceleration using this equation, so then AC will be the this is the final, let's say. Let's say this is the initial for this interval and this is the final, let's say. So we will write V minus V naught divided by T. So V is minus 6 and this is minus 3 divided by T. So this is negative, right? What I mean is that when the rocket is moving in the negative S direction, the velocity increases, but what is the increase in the velocity? That the increase in is in the negative sense, right? So this is negative, but this is negative as well, right? But this negative, this minus 6 meter per second is greater than minus 3 in the negative sense, right? So this means that the negative velocity direction is in the downward direction, right? And similarly, the change in velocity is also negative. This is the change in velocity, right? So this is change in velocity is also negative. So if the change in velocity is negative, so this means that the acceleration from V to C is also negative, right? So again, when the rocket was moving from A to B, so the change in velocity was negative. That is in towards the negative S, right? So this means that when the change is towards the negative, so then we will consider the acceleration as minus 9.81. And similarly, from B to C, the acceleration is also again acting in the negative S direction, right? So if the acceleration, if the change in velocity is towards the negative S, if towards the negative coordinate system that we have assumed, right? So then we will consider the acceleration as negative. So this is very important, right? So now we can solve this problem very easily, right? So when we use this equation from A to B, right? So for two points A to B, when the rocket is moving from A to B, so we can find SB. If we put the final position equals to SB in this equation, right? And the initial velocity is VA, right? So VB, this is the final velocity, so this is VB. So we can put in this equation that this is VB. VB square equals to VA square plus 2AC SB minus SA. Right, so this way, so when the rocket reaches at point B, so the VB comes out becomes 0 and this is 75. So when we put all the values, right, so only the SB is unknown in this equation. So SB comes out to be 327 meters. And as you people can see that the acceleration due to gravity when the rocket is moving from A to B is negative, right? So now if you want to find the velocity when the rocket hits the ground, so again we will use this equation, right? But we will consider the motion from B to C, right? So from when the rocket is moving from B to C, so then the initial velocity will be equal to VB, right? When the rocket is moving from B to C, right? So then the initial velocity will become VB and the final velocity will become VC, right? And the initial position will be what? So the initial position will be SB and the final position will be SC, right? And the final position will be SC when the rocket hits the ground, so SC will become 0, right? So now as we can see in this equation that VC square is equal to VB square plus 2AC SC minus SB. So VB is 0, right? So this is 0 when the rocket moves from B to C, so then VB is 0, we know it. Then this will be 2, and again this is very important that the acceleration due to gravity is minus 9.81, right? And SC is 0 and this is minus 327, right? So VC comes out to be 80.1 meter per second, right? And the direction is downward, right? So since the rocket is moving downwards, so then the velocity at point C will be downward, right? If we apply this equation between A and C, so then the initial velocity will be VA and the final velocity will be VC, right? And the initial position will be SA and the final position will be SC, right? So again we can use this equation, right? So the final velocity is VC, the initial velocity is VA and this is 2AC and the final position is SC and the initial position is SA, right? So when we put all these values in this equation, so again we get that same velocity. So in the note it is said that it should be realized that the rocket is subjected to a deacceleration from A to B of 9.8 meter per second, right? So when the rocket was moving from A to B, so the rocket was decelerating, and then from B to C it is accelerated at this rate, right? So from B to C it was accelerated, right? Furthermore, even though the rocket momentarily comes to rest at B, B equals to 0, the acceleration at B is still 9.81 meter per second square downward, right? So it is said that since the rocket at point B stops for a moment, but still the there is the acceleration, right? So the acceleration is again 9.81 meter per second square, and that is acting in the downward direction. So I hope you people would have understood this this problem and this negative sign of acceleration in the acceleration due to gravity in the whole motion, right? So this is very important. So once you people define your coordinate system, so then you people have to identify whether the particle is accelerating or decelerating. So if it is decelerating, if the particle is decelerating, so then you people have to put the sign according to your coordinate system, right?